good evening. I'm Dr. Jenny Smith, professor and chair of the English department and director of general education at North Central College. Welcome to In Our Academic Era, Taylor Swift and the Liberal Arts, affectionately known on campus as TayTalks. On a scale of 1 to 13, where 13 represents the highest of Swifties, I'm a solid 12. I listen to her music on loop. I'm like in the top 0.5% on Spotify. Always been a strong student. I anxiously await the release of Reputation, Taylor's version. And I have strong opinions about which vault tracks are best. We can talk about it. But I don't like know her blood type, so I'm not kind of weird about it. So I'm at a 12. I'm gonna put myself at a 12. I'm really excited that we're all here tonight to celebrate and critically analyze her body of work and her influence on our culture, really on a global culture. Whenever a college endeavors to study a figure or topic in popular culture, there are always those who will say nay. You know who I'm talking about. The Chads and the Brads, if you will. They will ask, shouldn't we be studying real artists and writers? Isn't college about preparing people for jobs, not talking about their favorite pop singer? Doesn't she just have too many boyfriends to be taken seriously? Luckily, because I was trained in the liberal arts, I asked these questions a different way. How do we define a real artist or writer? What does it mean to have both purposeful work and find joy in and out of our jobs? And why is it that women are always faulted for having too many or not enough boyfriends? So, on a scale of 1 to 13 for the liberal arts, I am a 13. The liberal arts teach you that the questions you ask determine the answers you find. A literary scholar like myself will see something different in Swift than a philosopher, who we'll hear from tonight, a mathematician, a physicist. Tonight, you'll get to hear from scholars in physical therapy and sports management about how Swift can teach us about human movement and the business of sport. Swift allows scholars from business and political science to explore the meaning of gender in the 21st century. And our librarian, our research librarian, will teach us about how Swift presents a case study in the power of misinformation. So many people work to make tonight possible. This is on your program too. The individuals listed here went above and beyond their job descriptions. This event was made possible because of the collaboration across nearly every part of this campus. Will you join me in thanking the staff of North Central College? They really do make the whole place shimmer. Last February, I had the chance to gather with scholars from around the world in Melbourne, Australia, for the Swiftposium. There I am. It was one of three international conferences dedicated to her last year that I know about. There might be more that I don't even know about. Dozens of universities, including places like Harvard and New York University, offer classes in Swift studies. And a score of books and articles are forthcoming from popular and university presses. My own essay, subtle plug, is forthcoming in the literary Taylor Swift this very month. Now, yeah, thank you. I wrote this essay in 2021, and because scholarly publishing is somewhat ridiculous, it's still not out. She has produced like two totally new albums, one of which was a double album since this book has been published, or has been in press. Just really incredibly prolific artist. In the essay and in the conference presentation I gave in Australia, I look at, not dissimilar from Maggie just moments ago, how Swift's 2020 sister albums Folklore and Evermore weave a tapestry of allusions to literary modernists from F. Scott Fitzgerald to Ernest Hemingway to Robert Frost to E.E. Cummings. In one section, I focus in on her engagement, like Maggie did, with Charlotte Bronte's classic novel, and then with the retelling by Jean Rhys, Wide Sargasso Sea. By engaging with these two literary texts, Swift does what she does best. She reveals the truth and seriousness of women's inner lives in a world that so often seeks to deny us our truth. My students call this gaslighting. And no one calls it out better than Swift. And so, yes, I am a fan, but I am also a scholar. Tonight you will hear from just some of the amazing faculty at North Central. And as a side note, not all of the presenters tonight are Swifties. All are welcome. I hope you leave TayTalks with your friendship bracelets, but I also hope that you leave North Central College with the knowledge that you are, in fact, not alone, kid. Please welcome our first presenter, Associate Professor of Philosophy and the Assistant Dean of Interdisciplinary Studies, Shaheen Musa.